కృపావార్తా కార్యక్రమమునకు స్వాగతం. నేటి ధ్యానాంశము ఆహారము ఫుడ్. ఆయన యందు భయభక్తులు గల వారికి ఆయన ఆహారమిచ్చును. ద లార్డ్ provides food to those that fear him. What a wonderful assurance, what a wonderful hope in the word of God. We have hope. All those that are burdened and are heavy laden and are tired and are weary, come to me, I will give you rest. All those that are burdened and heavy laden, come to me, I will give you rest. This rest also involves the provision of food. This rest also involves the provision of milk. This rest also involves the abundant supply of wine. All those that are thirsty, come buy milk and wine and drink without paying any money, without paying any money. All the poor that do not have any resources, just come to me, buy wine and milk without giving money, and drink and be content and be satisfied. This is the compassion of Jesus Christ. This is the love of Jesus Christ. All around us we see so many people in hunger, in thirst, in poverty, without clothing, nakedness, without proper place to dwell in. Who are all these people? They are all Jesus Christ in disguise. In the book of Matthew chapter 25, we clearly see who are all these dying, who are all these destitute, who are all these homeless people that are naked, that are hunger, that are thirsty, that are sick, that are helpless, that are in captivity, in fear, in prison, in clinics, with so many kinds of sicknesses, being not attended by any helpers, not receiving any care. When we are in good health, when we are in comfortable situation, all are our friends, all are our relatives, many will come to us, will spend time with us to receive good from us. When you are in sickness, when you are in prison, when you are in loss, what will be the situation? When you are in loss, when you are in sickness, when you are in poverty, when you are in homelessness, it may so happen that some of your friends, some of your relatives may come. But what will they do? They will only grieve you. They will only hurt you. We see this in the life of Job so clearly. Job was a God-fearing person. Job was a righteous person, a prayerful person. Job is a man of prayer. Job was trusting in God with all his heart. in spite of being very rich, Job has never turned away from God. Usually it so happens that man turns to God only in the time of need, only when he is weak, only when he is sick, only when he is in need. But this is not the case with Job. Job, being blessed abundantly, having so much abundance, with so many riches, loved God with all his heart, with all his mind, with all his soul, with all his strength. Job fulfilled the first commandment. And what is the second commandment? And the second commandment is, love your neighbor as you love yourself. Job fulfilled the second commandment as well. In the beginning, at the threshold of the promised land, when the children of Jacob were going to inherit the joy, the surplus, the abundance, happiness, God is giving instructions to the children of Jacob. You should not deviate from what I tell you. So long as you have my word in your heart, you will be dwelling in peace, you will be in safety, you will be enjoying the good of the land, you will be enjoying the surplus of the land. I am going to make you dwell in this promised land, only few steps to go. You will enter into the promised land that I have shown to your fathers, that I have promised to your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. I am going to fulfill the promise that I have made to my friend Abraham, my servants, Isaac, my servants, Jacob. God is faithful. 450 years have passed. Abraham has rested in the Lord and inherited the celestial city. Likewise, Jacob, Isaac, slept in the Lord. God can very well neglect his promise, forget his promise. Did God do so? 450 years have passed. Yet, God is faithful in his promise. What God is doing all these 450 years? I have plans for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Man will be so much impatient, so much disappointed, discouraged. God is not answering my prayer. God is not listening to me. If God were to be there, why should I be in sorrow? So many complaints, so much mistrust. The children of Jacob has every legitimate reason to disbelieve the promise of God. Job has every legitimate reason to forego his faith in God. Did Job forego his faith? Did Job left his faith? No. In spite of fulfilling all the commandments of the Lord, just when the children of Jacob were at the threshold of the promised land, God is writing 10 commandments with his own hand. God is so strange for us now. The word God itself is so strange thing to man today. Who is God? Where is God? Is God existing? So much disbelief. Why? Because you have not allowed the author of faith into your heart. That is why there is no seed of faith. If there is no seed, how can you expect the sprout? If there is no sprout, how can you expect the plant to grow? When there is no plant itself, how can you get the tree? When there is no tree itself, how can you get the fruit of faith? How can you get the fruit of the Spirit? Only you can get the fruit of the Spirit. When your heart is fertile, your heart should be beautifully fertile soil. It should be plowed well. It should be soft. It should be plowed and all the hard spaces to be beautifully plowed and the soil to be watered. Hard stones and rocks to be taken away. Then when the word of the Lord fells in the soil, when it fells in the good soil that is plowed well, that is watered well, what will happen? The seed will bear much fruit. Some of the seeds will bear 30-fold fruit, others will bear 60-fold fruit, and others will bear 100-fold fruit. It all depends on how much you have plowed your heart, how much you have watered your heart. We are the co-workers of God and you are His field. You are destined to be fruitful, to be fertile, to be bearing much fruit, to be bearing the fruit that is promised in Psalm 128. Thus will a man be blessed, a man that fears God. First of all, we do not accept the existence of God. Fear of God is far away. Fear of God is a distant dream. Today's youngsters, if we make an interview, if we make a poll, elections are fast approaching in a nation that boasts to be founded on faith, to be founded on trust. Likewise, if we take a poll, if we take an election of youngsters, with one single question, do you believe in God? Obviously, the poll result will be less than 1% that will agree that they will believe in God. This is the present state of affairs. That is why we see so many pandemics. That is why we see so much anxiety. That is why we see so much lack of resources, scarcity for food, scarcity for housing, scarcity for clothing, scarcity of jobs, whatnot. Everything is scarce. A king has to care for the soil. How does the king know how to rule the people? Paul says our sufficiency is of God. Today's ruler says our sufficiency is on our bureaucrats that are so well educated. Our bureaucrats are educated in world-renowned universities. Our bureaucrat is from a world-famous university. Do you know who is my finance secretary? Do you know who is the chief of my planning commission? Do you know who is my scientific advisor? He has so many feathers in his cap. Feathers fallen from the wings, can they fly? My bureaucrats have so many feathers in their caps. They themselves are a white elephant to you, hindering the progress, hindering to take independent decisions. Can you take any strong decision with courage, with bravery? Can you write a law stating that all homeless are being provided with home this very day? No. Why? Because you have bureaucrats with so many feathers in their caps that cannot fly. What is the use of feathers that have fallen from the wings? Our bureaucrats have so many feathers in their basket, in their cap. So many eggs in their basket. Rotten eggs. Who can eat? If your bureaucrats were to have so many fruits in their basket, eggs in their basket, then why there are so many people dying of starvation? why there are so many youth going from pole to post out of hunger, out of joblessness, out of disappointment, out of discouragement. Your bureaucrats themselves are a white elephant hindering your progress. Paul said, our sufficiency is of God, our sufficiency is of God. Who can supply to all these needs? We trust in God. If it is indeed true, we will see fruitfulness. Joseph trusted in God. And God was with Joseph, and Joseph was successful, and there is much fruit. Joseph supplied much grain and prevented many from dying. We do not see such things happening in the nations boasting that their nations are founded on truth, their nations are founded on faith. Why? Our dependency is on bureaucrats with so many feathers in their caps, not able to fly. When there is life in the bird, it will fly. When it is already dead, with all its feathers dispersed away, what good is it for? The Lord will provide food to those that fear him. The fear of man is a snare, but the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Could you find the difference between what it is to fear man and what it is to fear God? When we fear man, it will become a snare to us. It will become a death trap. We'll be made slaves. If you say weak to any person, you will be exploited. The world is like that. The world will exploit, obviously, those that are without help, those that are without any advocate. Injustice will be done to those that cannot afford an advocate for themselves. But Jesus Christ promises, I myself am your advocate. I myself am your pleader. I will plead for your cause. I will render justice to you. I will render justice to the fatherless. I will render justice to the widow. Are you fatherless? Are you widow? Are you poor? Are you homeless? Are you sick? Are you in poverty? Are you in thirsty? Do not fear. We have the Savior that has left heaven and come to this world, and that Savior is none other than Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today and forever. మృతుడనైతిని కానీ ఇదిగో యుగ యుగములు సజీవునిగా ఉన్నాను. కాల్ అంటూ మీ ద డే ఆఫ్ ట్రబుల్ ఐ విల్ ఆన్సర్ యూ, ఐ విల్ డెలివర్ యూ అండ్ యూ విల్ గ్లోరిఫై మై నేమ్. జీసస్ క్రైస్ట్ ఈజ్ ద ఎవర్ ప్రెసెంట్ హెల్ప్. జీసస్ క్రైస్ట్ ఈజ్ ద కింగ్ ఆఫ్ కింగ్స్, ద లార్డ్ ఆఫ్ లార్డ్స్. జీసస్ క్రైస్ట్ డిపెండెన్సీ ఈజ్ నాట్ ఆన్ ద సూడో బ్యూరోక్రాట్స్ దట్ హ్యావ్ సో మెనీ యూజ్లెస్ ఫెదర్స్ ఇన్ దేర్ క్యాప్. Jesus Christ can take any courageous, bold decision. What could be a bold decision than offering his life as a ransom to redeem you? Can any king boasting that I am the ruler of over the greatest world democracies can offer his life to save you? If it is so, why there are so many homeless people all around the streets, in every nook and corner? Why there are so many hopeless, helpless people, homeless people in the railway stations, in the bus shelters? Are these kings not capable of providing shelter to them, or they do not have the love of God? It's as simple as that. They are of the world. How can they have the love of Jesus Christ? They do not know Jesus. Now, your neighbor as you love yourself. If you yourself were to be homeless, if you yourself were to be naked, if you yourself were to be hungry, How do you feel? Can you not feel the suffering of your neighbor? That is being unwanted, that is being rejected by everyone and left out, not having any hope. David was an ordinary shepherd. God has chosen to anoint David to be king over Israel. Why? Samuel, I repent. This is the second time God has stated that God is repenting. The first time God made this statement that God is repenting is during the times of Noah. During the times of Noah, the earth was filled with corruption. Today's world is no different from the days of Noah. We see all around corruption. That is the very reason why we see so much homelessness, so much joblessness, so much unemployment, so much violence, so much injustice, so much exploitation of the weak, so much exploitation of the helpless. Corruption. In the days of Noah, the earth was filled with corruption and violence. The earth was filled with corruption, and everyone has turned to his own way. Will God remain silent? He that has formed the ears, will he not listen? He that has formed the eyes, will he not see? Will he remain silent when injustice is so prevalent? When corruption is so prevalent? When the rulers ordained and supposed to care for the sheep, are no more obedient to the will of God? And the second time God was repenting is regarding Saul. God speaks to Prophet Samuel, Samuel, I repent for making Saul the king over Israel. He started rebelling against me. To listen is better than offering a sacrifice. So quickly, Saul's heart has turned away from the fear of God. No more fear of God. Where there is no fear of God, then evil of all kinds will prevail. How many of our youth believe in God, believe in the existence of God, know God? Teach the child the way he should go, and he will not depart from the way even when he grows up. We need to bring up our children in the fear of God. What Hannah did? When Hannah prayed to God, God has heard her petition and provided for her need. Hannah was childless. Hannah is being humiliated, mocked at by Elkanah's another wife that happened to have the children. In her agony, in her sorrow, Hannah turned to God and prayed in the temple of God in Shiloh. During those days, the temple in Jerusalem is not yet built by Solomon. Solomon happened to be the king after David. We are talking of the times of Judges. During those times where there is no king over Israel, God himself was ruling his children. God himself was ruling as king, the children of Jacob. In those times, during the times of the Judges, in Shiloh temple, Hannah was praying, seeking the grace of God, seeking the mercy of God, seeking the compassion of God. Where are such praying mothers? Praying mothers beget praying children. Why do we see so much disbelief in today's younger generation? It is because of prayerless mothers. Praying mothers are at a premium. Hannah's petition for a son has initiated a prayer movement. A great movement of prayer has started with a single petition of a praying mother Hannah. God can use your scarcity. God can use your tears. God can use your lack. God can use your mourning to turn your petition into a great moment of prayer that will bring forth prophets like Samuel. What a great blessing. Praying mothers are a great blessing. Praying mothers are at a premium. In these times of scarcity, in these times of much disbelief, faithlessness, praying mothers are at a premium. Praying mothers are needed. That will bring forth praying children. Samuel inherited the virtue of praying from his mother. At the very tender age, at the very young age, just when he has left receiving milk from his mother Hannah took Samuel while he was so young, while he was so tender, to fulfill her oath to God. While I was in helpless state, while I am being mocked by my own relatives, when I am in sorrow, in agony, in humiliation, I turned to God, and God turned my mourning into dancing. God turned my shame into honor. What do you lack? Do you lack children? Do you lack education? Do you lack admission in any good university? Do you lack academic degrees? Do you lack job? Your lack, your scarcity, your want, God will turn into a great dancing. God will turn into a great blessing. God will make you a great witness. There is a scarcity in the life of Hannah. God has turned her lack into joy. God has blessed Hannah with Samuel. The name Samuel means God hears. Why Hannah gave that name to Samuel? Because in the temple of Shiloh, when she was praying for the child, no words are coming from the mouth of Hannah. Just in her heart, in agony, she is pouring out her sorrow. She is pouring out her need, her want at the feet of the Lord. No words are there. God sees the heart. God knows our groanings. And God has blessed Hannah with a child. Because God has heard her prayer, Hannah says, Samuel, God hears. Samuel happened to be a monument of faith, a man of prayer. Samuel testifies like this: as for me, if I do not pray for you, it is a sin to me. It is regarded in the sight of God as a sin that I have committed on your behalf if I do not pray. Such is the prayerful life of Samuel. To such Samuel, to such prophet of God, God is speaking, Samuel, I repent for making Saul to be king over Israel. Today, if there were to be prophets like Samuel, God will say, Samuel, I repent for making this person to be king over this nation. Samuel, I repent for making this person to be king over this nation. And the list goes on and on and on and on. The reasons are many. Samuel, Saul started rebelling against me. Saul has lost the fear of God. On the contrary, the next king that took the throne was none other than the man after God's own heart, David. David was only an ordinary shepherd. His beginnings are so humble. While he was a shepherd, he was caring for the sheep. He was willing to forego his own life for protecting the sheep, for guarding the sheep. God has seen the care. God has seen the sacrificial love of David. Samuel, I have found a man after my own heart to be anointed over king over Israel, to be anointed as king over Israel. I have found a person of my own heart. In the wilderness, in the forest, with his little flock, what David is doing? Day and night, David is meditating on the word of the Lord, seeing the moon, seeing the stars, seeing the creation, seeing the sun. In silence, the sun, the moon, the stars are declaring glory to the Creator. What is the consequence? David has written 73 Psalms while being a shepherd. What an intimacy David has with God. David's life is founded on faith in God. If we ask today's youngsters, can we find at least one David today to be anointed as the king over his chosen people? Doubt. Where are David's today that God can so joyfully declare to his prophet Samuel, Samuel, I have found a person of my own heart. Go and anoint. We do not see such declarations. Blind people choosing blind kings, and nations are being doomed to destruction. It so happened that in the forest, there happened to be a gathering of all the trees. All the trees have, on one fine morning, wanted to have a king over them. We are a world's great forest. We are the forest of Arizona. We are the forest in the California. We are the forest in the Australia. We will never see any fire. We will be safe. We will be preserved. We will be hale and healthy. No fire will ever cause any harm to us. We will be evergreen. We are on our own. So, we will do one thing. We will have an election and choose a king to rule over us. And all the trees in the forest have gone to the grapevine. Grapevine, grapevine, you are so beautiful. You are giving plenty of grapes to us. We are being satisfied, you are grapevine. You are so good friend of us. We wanted to make you a king over us. We have elected unanimously. Only thing you have to do is you have to sign and receive the royal diadem and rule over us. The grapevine says, will I stop yielding my fruit that brings gladness to man and just shake with winds and reign over us and reign over you as the king? Will I stop fulfilling the will of God in my life? Will I stop doing the will of God in my life and out of my way, out of my destination, choose my own path and be a king over you? I will not be a king over you. Rather, I prefer to fulfill the will of my Creator God, to continue to yield much grape and satisfy with my wine the heart of men. This is what God has destined me, that I bear much fruit and satisfy His people, created in His image. The grapevine has denied. Then all the people, all the trees have gone to a olive tree. Olive tree, olive tree, you are so beautiful. You are so wonderful. Your oil is so precious. We have unanimously elected you to be king over us. only one step ahead to become the king. So if you approve, you can become the king over us and rule over us. We'll be your people. Then the olive tree says, should I stop yielding my precious oil that is used to light the lamp in the temple of God? Will I stop fulfill the will of God, purpose of God, out of my destiny, out of my path? Shall I listen to you and become king over you? That is not the purpose with which God has made me. God has a very will in my life. God has a very purpose in my life, and all my oil has to be used to be anointed, used for anointing of kings, used for the lighting of lamps in the temple. I will not be violating from the will of God. I will continue to yield my oil. I will not be king over you, the olive tree denies. Then all the trees in the forest will go to a thorny bush. Thorny bush, thorny bush. No one is willing. The grapevine has rejected to be king over us. The olive tree has rejected to be king over us. We are only left with you as the final and last option. So we wanted and we have unanimously elected you as our king. So be king over us. The thorny bush, having no good in it, willfully, joyfully agreed. Of course, now wisdom has come to you. You have turned to me. That has no fear of God, that has no knowledge of God, that has no purpose for God. You have come to the right person. I will be king over you. If by any chance, if you were to decide to dethrone me, I will cause fire, and with my thorny bushes I will burn all of you. Today's kings are like thorny bushes, causing much harm, becoming a white elephant to the people, becoming a great heavy stone on the neck of the people. Is it not so? So many people in tears, so many people in homelessness, so many people in joy. Where are kings like grapevines? Where are kings like olive trees? Where are kings like Joseph? Where are kings like David? Samuel, I repent for making this person king over this nation. Samuel, I am repenting for making this person to be king over this nation. Samuel declares to Saul, Saul, what have you done? I have done everything according to the will of God. I am both following the book, I am both following the constitution, I am following the bureaucrats, I am following the ministers, and as per the word of God, as directed by them, I am doing. If you are to do all things according to the word of God, then what are all these noises of the livestock that I am hearing? From where have you brought all these things? Who asked you to bring the defiled things, the cursed things that are an abomination in the sight of God? Who asked you to bring? Did God not warn you not to touch anything from that cursed place? Why do you rebel against God? God has left you. God has left you. This is the greatest curse any person, any ruler over the earth can have, if God were to forsake any person. his waste will be no different from hell. After many years, Samuel passes, rests in peace, and Samuel is gathered with his fathers. It so happens that there will be difficult times around the nation Israel. Enemies, armies were encamped. Israel were to be surrounded by armies of enemies. Saul was in fear. If God were to leave man, fear reigns in a person's heart. So long as God is with us, we'll be confident, we'll be brave, we'll be fruitful, we'll be flourishing. That is the very reason why we should always pray this prayer: Lord, abide with me. Lord, grant your spirit with me. Grant your presence with me. May your peace not depart from me. Haggai chapter 2. My spirit will be with you. My peace will be in this place. The later glory of this temple will be more glorious than the former glory. Ruth, your present character is far better than your previous character. What a wonderful blessing, what a wonderful testimony. Boaz has never seen Ruth. Yet Boaz is testifying regarding Ruth. Your present character is far better than your previous character. I have heard all the good you have done to your mother-in-law. All our deeds are recorded in the book of the Lord, in the memorial in the book of memory of the Lord. All our deeds are recorded, and we will be rewarded. If Boaz were to have a record of the things of the good that Ruth has done to Naomi, will God not have our record? The present glory of this temple will be much better than the former glory. We are destined for a better glory. My spirit will be with you. My spirit will be in this place. My peace will be in this place. What a comforting word. What a joyful blessing. What a great blessing. We should all pray for this blessing. Lord, may your spirit with me, be with me, abide with me. May your peace be with me. Haggai chapter 2. May my later glory be far better than the previous glory. We are destined for glory. Man has lost his glory, and those that believe in Jesus Christ will all regain their lost glory and are destined to eternity, destined for joy. All their losses will be replenished. If you lose anything for my sake, you will receive 100-fold in this earth and eternal life. This is the promise of Jesus Christ. Have you lost anything for the sake of Jesus Christ, for the sake of your testimony that you have given for the glory of God? No. You are not even willing to lose any of your wealth. Then how can you inherit the eternal life? What should I do to inherit the eternal life? You know very well the law. You know all the 10 commandments. Do as per the 10 commandments that God has commanded you, that God has instructed you just while your ancestors, while your fathers were at the threshold of the promised land. I was told by my fathers regarding the 10 commandments. From my very childhood, I was taught of the 10 commandments. I am very familiar with the 10 commandments of God, and I have been meditating on the 10 commandments of God, and I am fulfilling the 10 commandments of the God. Yet, one thing is lacking in you. One thing is lacking in you. Go sell all the riches and wealth that you have, distribute to the poor, and you come and follow me. The young person happened to have so much wealth, so many riches. He was so much grievous. He was so much disappointed to receive this answer. If you have such reservations, why at all you have to come and ask Jesus Christ, Lord, what should I do to inherit eternal life? If Jesus Christ will say the answer, do you have the ability to accept? Lord, what should I do to inherit eternal life? First of all, you do not believe that there is something like eternal life. All the 70 years is what you have in your hand, that is your faith. Man is not created for 70 years, man is not created for 80 years. You may be disappointed and you may be saying this 70-80 years itself is sufficient. No. All your tears will be wiped away. Your mourning will be turned into dancing. Greater joy, greater hope, greater love are awaiting. This 70 years or 80 years is only prove our allegiance to the God that has made us and sent us. I know from where I have come and I know to where I am going. We all should know from where we are sent and where we are going. Even you are conceived, even before you are conceived in your mother's womb, I know you. I have ordained you as a preacher. Even before you are conceived in your mother's womb, God is talking to Prophet Jeremiah. Do you know from where you have come? Do you know where you are going? God has sent us into this world to fulfill the will of God, to fulfill His purpose. Grapevine has a purpose. Olive tree has a purpose. They have realized their purpose and their will for God, will of God. We will not deviate from the will of God. We will continue to bear much grape, yielding much wine that satisfies the heart of man. I will continue to yield much olive oil that is used to ordain kings and that is used to light the lamp in the temple. This is the very purpose with which God has created me. I will not be moving here and there by being king over you. God has not commanded me to be king over you. I am bound to bear much fruit, to give much oil that strengthens the heart of man. Have you realized the will of God in your life? Are you yielding your wine to satisfy the heart of man? Are you yielding your oil to light the lamps of those in darkness? Shine forth your light that people will see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. How can we shine forth if we do not have the oil? How can we shine forth if we do not accept Jesus Christ as our Father? Let your light shine that people will see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. How can we have the power to shine without Jesus? I am the light. Jesus Christ is the true light. When we receive the true light into our heart, we will continue to shine forth the light and we will do the deeds of our Father, Jesus Christ. And our Father will be glorified by our deeds. Neti dhyanam samo aharamo. Food. పరలోకము నుండి దిగి వచ్చిన జీవాహారం నేనే. ఐ ఆమ్ ద హెవెన్లీ మన్నా దట్ హ్యాస్ కమ్ డౌన్ ఫ్రమ్ హెవెన్ టు సాటిస్ఫై యువర్ హంగర్. దోస్ దట్ ఈట్ దిస్ మన్నా విల్ నెవర్ పెరిష్. రిసీవ్ జీసస్ క్రైస్ట్ టుడే యాజ్ యువర్ పర్సనల్ సేవియర్. పార్టేక్ ఇన్ ద హోలీ కమ్యూనియన్ దట్ ఈస్ ఆర్డైన్డ్ కమాండెడ్ బై గాడ్, that is instituted by Jesus Christ Himself. Holy Communion is the practice not instituted by man, it is not from man, it is from heaven. Do this to remember me, to remember my suffering, to remember my crucifixion, so that you will be partakers of my resurrection. As Jesus Christ has been crucified for all the sins of mankind, we are all died of our sins. And just like as Jesus Christ has risen victoriously from the dead, we will also rise from the dead to give us eternal hope, to make us righteous. Christ has risen from the dead, means all our sins are buried. No more sins will have any power on us. No more tears will have bitterness. Death cannot have a final say. Do not fear those that kill your body and can do nothing to your soul. What does that mean? Do not fear the Satan. Satan will come to you with so many accusations, so many threats. Satan will show you hunger. Satan will show you joblessness. Will blackmail you with so many things. I will put you in prison. Okay, you put. Nothing is going to happen to me. Even if I were to be in prison, God will be present with me. Daniel was put in lion's den. What has happened? Will a hair from his head has fallen on floor? No. Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego were thrown into fiery furnace. What has happened? Has one of their heads been burnt in fire? No. Then are you not more precious than the birds of the sky and the beasts of the earth? If God were to care for them and provide them and sustain them, will He not provide you? God has given food to those that fear Him. Tana priyulu nidrinchuchundaga ayana variki anugrahinchunu. When His loved ones are while at sleep, God will prepare a table for them. God will provide them. Why do you worry regarding your food? Is not life greater than food? If God Himself were to give the life, will He not sustain your life by providing the heavenly manna? Should you worry for your food? Should you worry for your job? Should you worry for your home? I am homeless. Christ is with you. Christ Himself is with you, and He is also as homeless as you. While you are homeless, Christ is with you. While you are in hunger, Christ is with you. When you are naked, you are not alone. Christ is with you. That is why Jesus Christ so clearly says, loud and clear, I am naked, I am hunger, I am in prison, I am sick, I am in hospital, I am in clinic, I am hunger, I am thirsty. How long? Your homelessness cannot last more than 70 years or 80 years. After that, the angels of God themselves will come and carry you on His bosom, on their bosom to rest, on the bosom of Abraham in the heaven for an endless time. All the tribulations that we are facing today are nothing, are just a speck of dust, are less than a drop of water compared to the eternal weight of glory that is awaiting us. So, should you deny Jesus Christ, should you go away from Jesus Christ because you are homeless, because you are jobless, because you are poor, because you are naked, because you are sick? No. I am diagnosed with cancer, so I will leave Jesus. You will leave Jesus. What other hope you have? By the wounds you have received, by the wounds Jesus Christ has received, we are healed. I am diagnosed with cancer. I will cling onto the bosom of Jesus Christ. I will rest on the bosom of Jesus Christ. By the wounds He has received, He will heal me. Amidst agony, amidst sorrow, amidst all my losses, He will comfort me, He will console me, He will wipe away my tears. With His promises, He will sustain me. This is the stand you should take. I am diagnosed with cancer, I am diagnosed with AIDS, I am in prison. How long? Not for eternity. All the tribulations that man is going through, the losses man is going through, are only for a while, and they are nothing compared to the eternal weight of glory that is prepared for us. Who has seen eternity? Who has seen the promised land that is promised to Jacob? Are we not seeing and are we not hearing in the news regarding Israel, the promised land? Ah, we are reading so much about 70% homelessness. We are hearing so much about the spread of pandemic. This this is the consequence of disobedience to God. If you leave my word and go away in your own path astray and do the things of the people that the land that was inhabited previously and whom the land has vomited before you, you will also meet the same fate. God has clearly warned, loud and clear. Abraham, your children will inherit the promised land, flowing with milk and honey, flowing with peace, flowing with abundance, the land on which my eyesight will be present from the year beginning to the year ending. The pestilence, when it has come to the field of Ornan, has stopped. When the sword of the angel has come to the field of Ornan, God said, stop, enough. There is someone that is fearing God, Ornan. In the fields of Ornan, God has seen a God-fearing person stop, and the angel of God stopped killing. No more pestilence, no more deaths. The deaths are stopped, the pestilence is stopped. Where is Ornan? Where are the fields of Ornan? If there are the fields of Ornan, the angel of God will stop the pestilence. The moment the angel of God raised its hand in the field of Ornan, God said, stop, enough, no more harm, no more pestilence, no more curse. We need people like Ornan. What God has seen in the field of Ornan is still a mystery. Yet Ornan has a heart of giving all to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. David comes to the field of Ornan and asks, I want this field to offer sacrifice for the Lord. Ornan is so humble. Take all for the God. All that I possessed is the gift from God, is the grace of God. I will not hesitate to give this field to you to offer sacrifices to the Lord. Take it freely. No, not like that. I do not want it for freely. Tell the price, I will buy the field, and then I will offer my sacrifices to the Lord that has been gracious to me and stopped the pestilence over this nation. Where are people like Ornan willing to sacrifice all that have for the Lord? Where are kings like David that repent for their wrongdoings? నేటి ధ్యానాంశము ఆహారము ఫుడ్ ద లార్డ్ ప్రొవైడ్స్ ఫుడ్ టు దోస్ దట్ ఫియర్ హిమ్ ఆయన ఎందు భయభక్తులు గల వారికి ఆయన ఆహారము దయచేయును జీవాహారము నీవే జలము నీవే జీవాహారము నీవే జీవజలము నీవే ఐ ఆమ్ ద బ్రెడ్ ఆఫ్ లైఫ్ దోస్ దట్ డ్రింక్ ఫ్రమ్ మీ విల్ నెవర్ థర్స్ట్ Taste and see that the Lord is good. This is my body, offered as a ransom for the forgiveness of your sins. This is my blood, shed for the forgiveness of sins of many. The moment you receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior for the atonement of your sins, you are judged as righteous in the sight of God. You are clothed by the righteousness of Jesus Christ, and you will continue to remember the crucifixion of Jesus Christ by taking part in the Holy Communion. The things of God for the people of God, the heavenly manna that has come down from heaven